On your favorite festival of colors, Holi, how can you miss out on relishing these creamy malpuas flavored with fennel and peppercorns, dunked in saffron-infused sugar syrup? So what all we need? We have about 250 grams of unsweetened khoya or mawa, 200 grams of maida or refined flour, 2 to 3 tablespoons of suji or semolina, about 200 grams of sugar, 50 grams each of milk and curd, and the two most important spices for the malpua, fennel and peppercorns. And we also got some cardamom and saffron to flavor our sugar syrup. Let's start by roughly crumbling the mawa in our mixing bowl. Knead the mawa with gentle hands. Now add half the curd, that is about 25 grams, to the mawa and knead again with gentle hands. Add the remaining half of the curd and continue to mix and knead. Knead till it becomes a smooth paste without any lumps. Now we'll add half the maida to the mawa paste. Mix and knead with gentle hands. Add the rest of the maida too and keep kneading till it all combines well. Once the maida and the mawa have combined well, add in 2 tablespoons of suji and blend it all together. And once the mawa, maida and the suji forms into a soft pillowy dough, keep it aside for 5 minutes to settle in. After about 5 minutes, add the milk to the dough and start kneading again. To make the process easier, you can definitely use a stand mixer, but the microbes present in your hand will help in speeding up the process of proofing of the final dough. Add butter and mix till you get a batter-like consistency. Mix till you achieve a smooth, fine, no lump batter. Now let's grind the two most important spices, fennel and peppercorns. Make sure you add these to your malpua to get the authentic flavor. Grind it into a coarse powder and add it to the dough. And in case you have used a stand mixer to mix the dough, make sure to add a pinch of baking powder. Combine everything well and keep it aside for 15 to 20 minutes. Now while the dough is getting proofed, let's get going and make our saffron and cardamom infused sugar syrup. In a hot pan, add 3/4 cup of water to 1 cup of sugar. Also add in the crushed cardamom and few strands of saffron. Let the sugar melt and the syrup thicken. Remember, we do not require the string consistency, but we require a thick and a heavy syrup. It should stick between the fingers but not form strings. Once our sugar syrup is ready, let's fry our malpuas. And to get the flavorful and delicious malpuas, we must use ghee. The batter is thick, smooth and fluffy. Now to the hot ghee, we'll pour the batter in circular shapes. We need to shallow fry them in low heat. Now slowly turn it to the other side. Flip it one more time. Your malpua will always be crispier on the edges. Once both the sides are done, remove it from heat. Repeat the same process with the rest of the batter. Now we'll dunk our hot and creamy malpuas in the saffron and cardamom infused sugar syrup. Leave the malpuas for about 15 minutes to soak up all the sugar syrup. Sprinkle some almonds and your malpuas are ready to be relished. Do like and comment on the video and don't forget to subscribe to my channel, Deepa's Cookhouse.